My name is Myra, and I welcome all of you to this webinar arranged by Kites Innovation and UY Incubated. Now, if you have been following our webinars, you know that we bring you some of the greatest and some of the most amazing speakers from all over India to our webinars, who become then our mentors and our speakers. So similarly, today we have arranged this webinar for all of you, for the whole India. And if you have been following, also you should know that all of our events have some theme, they have some topic to them. Now today's event, if you have been following, you also might know that today's event also has a theme to it. Now, the theme of today's event is Make in India. And we here with Kites Innovation and UY Incubated, we believe that Make in India is possible with innovative mindsets. Now, to support that idea, we have our first honorable and amazing intellect, our speaker with us present. Now, I want to say a few lines with due respect for our first speaker, who is going to be Dr. Vignesh Venkatraman. Now, we have had the pleasure of having him with us before as well, and we welcome him with all our hearts. He is the Associate Professor and the Ambassador at IIC Department of Computer Science and Engineering, KPR Institute of Engineering and Technology, Coimbatore. Now, he's going to teach us about innovating education and education for innovation. Let me repeat that. Innovating education and educating for innovation. Now, that is going to be our honorable speaker's topic today. Sir, with warm regards, with a loads of respect, we welcome you to our session. We want you to start your session, sir, and also turn on your camera as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Samira ma'am, and for giving me this opportunity for Team Kites and UY Incubated team. Thank you for one and all present here. So I would like to, I'm going to thank for the team. And I'm going to present this particular session on innovating education and education for innovation. So in the topic itself says that how we want to bring an education in the form of innovative manner. What are the technologies, what are the advanced technologies we want to adapt it for the students to bring the particular education in a form of innovative manner. And how these practices want to be, how these practices to be, could be included in the education system. So this is the thing. Well, what are the things that we want to be considered when you are going to be make the particular system in an innovative manner, that you, how we want to bring the students in a creativity, we want to increase the capacity of creativity and make the students to be in a fact finder concepts and inspire in the form of learning methodology. We want to inspire them. And we want to bring out various ideas. We want to put forth the we want to bring them bring their ideas to the in the form of concept, and we want to invent them, and we want to develop them, and we want to bring to the latest technology. So all these concepts, when you have been bringing together, then the education system will be in a form of innovative one. So innovation in education is a possible sector which is a resistant character system. Resistant to change, it faces to a crisis of productivity and efficiency. When we have been put forth the system innovation concept in education, it improves the quality of education as well as in the form of bunk for the bunk in times of budget pressures and rising of demands. So we can able to make the system, then we want to bring the system by innovating practices, new practices to the education system. So it may, it brings a why and what the system brings you to the education. So effective skill strategies as to the strategies for the for, by the students can will be in an effective manner. They can able to develop their skills, both technical and non-technical skills and interpersonal skills in an effective manner. They can able to sound and open and competitive business. They will be there. This is a sound, open and competitive business environment. They can able to have a target. They can able to bring out their importance to, for the competitive business environment, how we want to behave and how we want to compete the environment by our technical skills and advanced technologies. Sustain public investment in an effective system of knowledge creation and diffusion. Here we want to give an, we want to invest, we want to invest more, and we want to give the sustainability in the public environment, and by giving an effective system of knowledge creation and diffusion system and increasing access and participation in the digital economy, and sound governance and implementation process. These are the various important highlights to bring an innovation in an education system. So what are these types of innovation practices are being there? We can go for product innovation, process innovation, and marketing innovation, and organizational innovation. So the product innovation, then we can able to develop a new product, and we can, with the help of the new components, materials, technical specifications, and incorporated softwares, and user friendliness, all the functional characteristics of the particular product. Man, this particular product should be in an innovative manner, and it should be in a form of user friendly, and it should be creative in nature. That's what we call it, product innovation. Process innovation deals about the improvement in the production and delivery method, how the process to be developed, how the product to be developed, and how it should be delivered, in what way it should be delivered. So there are certain techniques and equipments and softwares are being used to for the development of the product and
sorry for the interruption. I think somebody has to mute. There is a noise behind. Yeah. Yes, sir. Please go ahead, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Marketing innovation brings that the implementation of new marketing methodologies to bring the particular product design and packaging and product placement and product promotion. So let's consider here we can able to marketing innovation from the form of design thinking approach, how the particular product could be placed into the market. Now recent technology of design thinking approach, and they can able to bring about the various technologies to bring methodologies to bring the particular product to the market. Then organizational innovation is nothing but bringing the organizational system in an innovative manner by practicing new technological and new methodologies to incorporate the customers, to motivate the customers, and to bring out the customers to within existing relations. And we can able to bring out the new organization business practices and workplaces and the external relations too. So how to bring an innovation? What's the difference? What are the various important highlights when compared to innovation, reform, and change? The innovation, then, but we are bringing in new ideas to improve the knowledge and practices and their existing skill set. But reform is nothing but structure of conscious process of reproducing changes. That's nothing but the existing to make can change. That we call it reform. Change is nothing but total alteration of the intended phenomena. So what are the key highlights, characteristics for the innovation system is novelty and bringing the benefits to the market. And the reforms produce change, some cases in little or in the form of more, we can able to bring out the changes. And historical, consensual, and processual changes may happen when bringing a reform to innovation process. So the what we have seen about the process, product, marketing, and organizational innovation. But when you're going for a reform, only radical and incremental changes. That means by step-by-step manner, we can able to change. That's all. So what are various methods for innovation in education? The measures of innovation in education is nothing but providing indicators based on existing international data set. It aims to provide educational policy makers. Let's take currently we are going to step into national educational policy system, how the particular educational policy of the existing scenario will become to the new environment. So let's take in the existing scenario plus 2 up to 12 plus 3 plus 3 plus 2 plus existing scenario, but the new current technology we are going to seek about 10 plus 3 plus 3 plus 2, like that. Like that, we are going to 8 plus 3 plus 3 plus 2. Like this new system is going to be having certain new policies. So in bringing the system in a form of an innovative manner. The second thing is we are bringing the current trend, how we are making the children form of through the in a form of digital environment. We are going to take our education to the digital environment by Google platforms and Google Meets and Zoom Meets, etc. So in the current days, the education system going beyond the innovative approaches. So there are two approaches have been used for measuring innovation. One is the thing called tertiary graduation, including working in education and innovation in their workplace. Let's consider that we can able to have certain softwares, but students can able to educate themselves through in the form of animated videos and in the form of Google Classroom. The teacher will record the video and they can able to post them. Those things have been in the form of new technological practices have been adapted for educational system. To educational system. Then analyzing organizational changes through teacher-student services, surveys that we can able to what make changes, bringing the teacher and student in the form of good their goodwills, etc. There are large increases in innovative pedagogic practices across real-life higher-order skills and data and the text interpretation, personalization of teaching, etc. So these are the areas have been covered in form of pedagogy methodologies, new innovative pedagogy methodologies, and how the students want to teach and learn by themselves via the teaching methodologies and learning platforms of the learning e-learning platforms, and they can able to go for practices like implementing the chart preparation on model preparation, etc. All those things can be incorporated and they can able to bring out their innovative concepts, innovative ideas in the form of realistic one. Then the teachers have been innovating the use of assessment and this accessibility methodologies by bringing a new type of assessment methodologies, and they can able to incorporate them by having some rubrics methods. So, what are the various, what methodology does a particular student follows? What are the what's an innovative ideas he have been adapting into the particular methodology? And how for the particular system, how for the student bring their concept in an innovative one, like bring their concept to the environment like that. Those things have been evaluated, those parameters are evaluated under the teaching learning process. The education organization also bringing an area of special education by bringing new setup of labs and the teacher evaluation systems and evaluation of analyticals and building relationship between external stakeholders and interacting with the parents to bring out the new ideas how the teacher can communicate with the students in an effective manner. In general, the various countries have gained a greater level of innovation by increasing the educational outcome, including higher level education, plus the 8th grade per max performance and the earning equitable learning outcomes for students to all abilities and most satisfied teachers too. The innovative education system has a higher level of expenditure than a non-innovative system is nothing but fees constraints. So let's consider about by a non-educational, non-innovative system makes that the students want to go to the classroom, they want to put forth some more ideas, spend their time for 8 hours in the classroom, they want to teach, and the teacher will teach the lesson, etc. But current days, the new system takes about that a particular teacher comes into one meet, the students also comes into one meet, they can able to share their ideas, they can able to build their innovative practices, and they can able to showcase their talents and skill sets between the teachers and student relationship. It will be increased. But there are some difficulties too for the teachers and for the students to bring out their skill set, to increase their skill set over here. So there will be some limitations, but there will be more advantages in the innovative practices. So the educational and the skill dimension of innovation is nothing but the successful innovation brings an economical and social relationship in a good foundation of educational and the skills development system. How the human shapes the innovations and innovation. So skilled people generate knowledge that can be used to create and implement the innovation system over here. So skilled interact synergically with other inputs to the innovation process, including capital investment. Skill enabled entrepreneurship. We are having the knowledge. We are giving some inputs to the innovation process. The entrepreneurship is nothing but a career of innovation. Then the particular person can make as a developer, or they can able to have a startup, and they can able to come by an entrepreneurship to develop their skill set and their experience to the enterprise growth and survival. The skilled users and consumers of products and services often provide suppliers with valuable ideas for improvement too. The human shapes and innovations have been grouped into three broader categories. One is the based on subject-based skills and thinking and creativity and behavioral and social skills too. So in subject-based skills, they can able to represent their knowledge and how in a particular, and they can able to come to know how to develop their skills and in a particular field. They want to come to know how to develop the skills over here. The thinking and creativity here, you have to include both higher order skills and creative cognitive habits. So the cognitive habits involves in 3-5 different categories of knowledges based upon the remembrance and based upon the applying the concepts and analyzing the concepts and evaluating the concepts and making the minimum of executing the concepts, all evaluating the concepts and executing the concepts. That's a 5-6 different categories they can able to compete in the environment. Based on the 6 different cognitive habits, they can able to put forth the skills and they can able to develop the skills and they can able to bring the skills to an higher order level from the lower to higher order. Then they can able to see about the competencies include critical faculties and imaginations and the curiosity how they been build their knowledge and build their ideas to the innovative manner. The behavioral and social skills including such as self-confidence, leadership and management, collaboration and persuasion. So with the help of this behavioral and social skill, they can develop their skills, self-confidence, leadership and management, collaboration and persuasion. So the innovation strategies in education have the international review from the international review by the author Schooler 2010 of the NEA National Educational System concluded its relevance to the international community with therefore four important parameters. One is the thing called identifying of sectoral innovation system in an education sector and analysis to assess its performance. Second one is bringing the well-developed sectoral innovation system by contributing significantly the performance of education system by giving a key policy goals to the education sector. The third one is the coherent government strategy to develop the sectoral innovation system of education. The fourth process in approaching of innovation research and innovation policy thinking in an education sector can help the strategy emerge. So all those four strategies have been involved in a good framework to bring together to key partners interested in improving the quality of educational parameters. So let's have a detailed diagram. What is the aim over here? What is the main effective teaching and successful learning methodology have been bringing as a goal of the particular educational system in an innovative manner? The objective of this nothing but well-functioning national education sector innovation system. This is NESIS, National Education Sector Innovation System over here. What are the various fields of intervention over here? One is a thing called developing regularity, institutional and organizational framework. Under this category, we are bringing about the stakeholders, and we can able to reviewing the sector specific regulations from the perspective of innovation, drawing a map of the organization, strengthening link between research practice and policy, supporting networks and communities of practices, developing a financing model adapted to our objectives and priorities. So these are the four categories over here. Second thing is improving human conditions. So by improving the human condition, the teaching learning process have been improved, exploring the human resources over here, by which it may help innovation, strengthening of R&D research and development by the professionals, which we can able to strengthen our self-motivation, and developing career models and competence standards, training wider group of participants in the framework of initial in-service training of teachers, strengthening leadership, organization, and organizational development. All these set of parameters which is used to improve the human conditions for the development of, for developing the innovation system, education sector innovation system. How to ensure this quality? The ensuring quality by strengthening the quality management and assessment functions, and linking quality and innovation in sector level policy making, and defining quality in light of practical needs and exploiting the potential of international cooperation. So these all these set of parameters which is used to ensure the quality of the educational system. How to improve the knowledge management? We can able to improve the knowledge management by activating the communication cooperation by activating the communication system and cooperation among the participants, by conducting some group discussion, by enhancing the skill set via some contest series, webinar series, etc. So closing of knowledge gaps, the bridging of the gaps between an industry and the academia by to improve the knowledge management by giving the student, by imparting the students to the internship on implant training and industrial visits too. The national and international cooperation of research and development capacities, supporting the exchange and the dissemination of the knowledges between the one student to another student via sharing their ideas in general platforms and sharing good practices, reviewing the initial and in-service of teaching and of teachers. Then last one is nothing but the potential technological development, making new educational technology accessible, supporting through funding arrangements, removing and replacing obsolete technologies. Now all these old technologies will be removed in the current current education system, and we can able to incorporate new innovative and teaching methodologies to enhance the skill set of the students, which can able to use for assessment and accreditation system for new technologies too. Creating an environment which supports the development and competencies needed for the application and the new technologies. All those innovation focused by ICT technologies, information communication technology strategies for education. So upon all these set of strategies, all these fields of intervention, developing regularity and improving the human condition and ensuring the quality and improving the knowledge management and potential and technical development brings to the implementation of building upon existing components and combining top and bottom up approaches, relying on synergies arising from application of multiple tools, taking into account the specifier of different level of education policy making, then account the expected contributions, giving key attention to time frames and ensuring coherence and exploiting synergies rising from links, etc. These are the things that have been aimed for national education sector and national education sector innovation system practices. So manifesto of the particular European year of creativity and innovation established a major role over here. Creativity levels. One is a nurture creativity in lifelong learning process and making the schools and universities bringing the students and teachers engage in creative thinking and learning, transform workplaces into learning sites. So instead of going for a workplace, we can able to going for learning websites like online web learning. Then promote of strong, independent and diverse cultural sector, sustain the intercultural dialogues over there. We can able to promote scientific research to understand the world, improve people's lives and stimulate innovations and promote design process and thinking and tools. Then support business innovation that contributes to prosperity and sustainability. What are the various conditions for the education system to redesign the innovative learning? This makes the system to education to innovating practices. So we can able to reduce the standardization, fostering innovation, broadening the institution level. Second thing is we can able to appropriate the accountability and metrics of 21st century learning process over here. So this makes this particular appropriate accountability and metrics, and we can able to increase the metrics parameters to bring out the students in a way, students ideas in a creative nature, and we can able to adapt the methodologies to promote the students learning capacities too. Promoting learning leadership, trust and learner agency. So widespread of collaborative expert professionalism, ubiquitous professional learning, connectivity and extensive digital infrastructure, flourishing cluster of networking and partnership, powerful knowledge system and cultures of evaluation. So these are the various conditions to make the particular system, current education system, to be redesigned for new adaptive innovative learning environment. Thank you. Any queries?
So anybody has any questions? So till we have we pick up any questions, first of all, our first speaker and our first mentor, Dr. Vignesh Venkatraman, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for being with us today.
Thank you, ma'am.
And now we are waiting eagerly for any questions, whether anybody wants to ask anything. So I think we do not have any question, and amazing session. I think everybody just absorbed all of the information, and we are ready to move ahead, sir. Now, Ms. Letha Nahar has some question. Ms. Letha, just I would request our team to let Letha, yeah, unmute. There you go.
Good evening, one and all. This is Letha Nahar from Bangalore. My question here is, now we are talking about a lot of innovations and a lot of different things that we want to bring into education sector to make India Atmanirbhar. Now, we talk about all this, but do we have personnel, do we have people, do we have teachers, educators, trainers who can take these things forward? Are they equipped with that?
Ma'am, thank you, ma'am, Letha, ma'am. Currently, we are moving step into the forward of the new technology, but right now we can't able to give full-fledged 100% to the new technology level because the students are far away due to this particular pandemic situation. So we can, our environment to our Indian culture is going to be bring out the new technology of National Educational Policy 2.0, which have been going to end up in the current days. So this particular educational policy makes the student in, to students and faculty members to bring to the new environment of innovative manner.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Perfect. So let's move ahead. We have a few hand raises, sir. So we are going to take each of you one by one. Now, Ms. Lalitha Jaswal, Ms. Lalitha Jaswal, just go ahead and ask your question. Ms. Lalitha, you have the authority to unmute yourself right now. So please ask your question as we await. Okay, let's move ahead till until this one is figured out. Mr. Manoj Kumar Singh also has some query that he wants to discuss with us. Perfect. So Mr. Manoj, you can unmute your mic and ask your question right away. I'm just wondering whether you deliberately raised your hand, whether you want to ask anything or... Also, Mr. Ghosh, I am unmuting. Okay, perfect.
Hello?
Ghosh, yes, please go ahead.
I would like to ask a question. Modern education system is very beneficial to all the students. Sir?
Sir, yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you, sir. This one of them, Ghosh, sir. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Modern education system, we can't able to predict about the modern education system right now, sir, because we are going to incorporate the modern education system in the forthcoming years too. So this system, how the particular education, how to bring out the education system, how it will bring the education system, whether the students will adapt it or the faculty, the teachers, teacher relation will adapt it to the students, etc. We can't able to determine it, sir. Because 50% we can able to expect, because in the current days, due to this particular situation, the current days brings the system to in the form of web learning methodology. So the same thing will be adapted very easily by the students, because the students have been forget about the teaching system of the existing teaching methodology. So I think most probably it will be very easy to adapt by the students.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, everybody. I think that is all for the questions, sir. Thank you so much once again for being with us today, for sharing with us all of that knowledge that you have shared with us today.
Thank you, ma'am.